like we were discussing, you know, Six Sigma got its birth, if you were to call it, in Motorola, and you had a business challenge, which you referred to as Project Y. Instead of handling the Y superficially, you set out to identify the X's of your Project Y. You set out to establish statistical relation between X and Y. And instead of attending to Y superficially, you would end up looking at your X's so that Y is permanently improved. I'd like to share a very, very small story. We often, in our training programs, we'll often share a story about a particular museum in France. There was this particular museum in France which had a strange attribute to it, if I were to call it. The paint of the outside of the museum would dye every 2-3 months. Every 2-3 months, the French government had no option but to keep repainting the museum. Came in several engineers, completed the painting exercise, went back, came in, painted, went back, attending to the Y superficially. Several times later, came in a newer engineer. He said, "No, what is so special about this museum? Why does the paint wear out so soon? No, we've been handling similar monuments in similar climatic conditions, similar temperatures, etc., etc. What is so special about this museum that it dies so often?" Perturbed, he sought advice from his boss. He said, "Boss, would you happen to know why does the paint of the museum die?" Boss said, "No, I don't have a clue." He didn't give up. He spoke to his boss's boss. He said, "Sir, you are more learned. You have more experience. Would you have some clue?" The boss's boss said, "No, I also don't have a clue." Finally, he gave up. He said, "Nothing doing. Let's paint the thing and move on." The same night he was being served the food by the caretaker of the museum, almost sarcastically, he asked the old man, "No one else in the world knows. Would you happen to know why does the paint of the museum die?" He said, "Very simple, sir. Haven't you seen that there are thousands and thousands of pigeons here in the museum? And these pigeons are dirtying the wall of the museum. And the pigeon poop is so nasty on the paint that we have to use a chemical to take it off. And that chemical is very harsh on the paint. And thus the paint wears out." Enlightened as he was, he said, "So why do you think there are so many pigeons?" The basic need of a bird, you know, what would a bird want? Easy food, easy shelter. This is an old museum. These pigeons have made their nests almost everywhere. So they have easy place to stay. And there are thousands and thousands of spiders here. So easy food. What else would a bird want? He says, "Then why do you think there are so many spiders here?" "Well, the same story, sir. Easy food, easy shelter. These spiders have been here for a very, very long time. So they have spider webs all across the museum. Easy place to stay. And easy food because there are so many ants here." Curious as he was, he says, "Okay, so old man, can you give me an improvement plan?" He said, "I would advise that you first take care of the ants, the spiders and the pigeons, and only then should the paint be redone." He agreed. He sought the necessary financial approvals, got the disinfectants done, ant pores were closed, spider webs removed, spiders killed, pigeons' nests destroyed, and pigeons taken care of, and that the paint was done. The story says that the paint lasted there for 3 years and 2 months. There are two morals of the story. A, that instead of superficially attending to your issue, you must identify the spiders and the pigeons and the ants of your story. Once you attend to them, your problem Y will be permanently taken care of. Yet importantly, the moral of the story number two was that the root cause of the problem will often come from the caretaker of the museum. Listen well to the process voice. Listen well to the on-the-ground team. Build an infrastructure of getting your employees to participate. I will discuss that in greater detail as a part of Six Sigma as a philosophy.